Hello friends, we'll start today lecture number 9, which is riser design. Here we are going to see the design of the riser, and we'll also be solving the questions, but only after the complete design of the riser is completed in one or two lectures. So let us start. Now before starting the design of the riser, we must first understand that what is a riser. To understand what is a riser, we have already discussed about the riser in our previous lectures. You must have understand that the riser is an assembly which is attached above the casting so as to fulfill the demand of the volume that is shrinked at the time of solidification of the riser. Now solidification has been of three kinds. What were these? Liquid solidification, liquid shrinkage, solidification shrinkage and solid shrinkage. We have learned in the previous lecture that in the case of liquid and solidification shrinkage, the amount of material that is decreased or at the time of shrinkage, the material which is needed is fulfilled by the riser. Riser is going to provide the extra material, which extra amount of volume of the material which has got shrinked. And in the case of solid contraction or solid shrinkage, the thing that was given, allowance was given at that for the thing of to compensate the solid shrinkage. Now see what will happen is, first of all we'll understand, I'll make a diagram. Now again, this is hamari casting, ye meri casting hai, this is the casting, and casting ka ye design hai hamara, and this one is the riser, this is the cavity, and this one is the riser. Now riser, what riser will do is, at the time of the solidification of the casting, during what? During liquid shrinkage and solidification shrinkage. इन दोनों श्रिंकेज के टाइम पे जो भी श्रिंकेज आएगा तो उसका कंपनसेशन कौन देगा? दैट कंपनसेशन इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द राइजर. नाउ सी द राइजर, वी हैव टू डिजाइन द राइजर. नाउ व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट अजम्पशन और द फर्स्ट रिक्वायरमेंट एट द डिजाइन ऑफ द राइजर? देखिए, जो राइजर हम डिजाइन कर रहे हैं उसके लिए हमारा सबसे पहला क्या होना चाहिए, क्या रिक्वायरमेंट है? देखिए, द थिंग इज दैट द कैविटी इन विच द लिक्विड मेटल इज पोर्ड, where the casting is to be created. Now what will happen if the casting जो है हमारी वो riser के पहले solidify कर गई तो बढ़िया है. अगर solidify riser के पहले कर गई तो shrink करेगी, riser हमारा अभी भी liquid phase में होगा तो क्या होगा, riser will give the required amount of the material that is needed to the casting for the shrinkage, for compensating the shrinkage. लेकिन अगर हमारा जो riser है, riser is solidifying before the casting, then what will happen that the riser तो पहले ही solidify कर गया. अगर riser पहले solidify कर दिया उसके बाद में हमारी casting solidify कर रही है, तो in that case what will happen is कि बाद में जो shrinkage आएंगे ना, तो liquid और solidification shrinkage बाद में आएंगे, at that time riser में liquid molten metal won't be available to feed the casting for the shrinkage. So ये हमारी, हमको क्या होगा, the casting जो भी मिलेगी वो हमारी कैसी casting मिलेगी, that will be a kind of defected casting, तो ऐसे तो हमारा काम चल नहीं पाएगा. Now what will happen is, for keeping this thing in mind that the riser must solidify after the cavity or the हमारी casting जो है वो solidify हो जाए, उसके बाद ही हमारा riser को solidify होना चाहिए. Now see, जो हमारा solidification time था, solidification time was directly proportional to volume by area का square. Now what I want that the time of solidification of riser must be maximum. We must understand that if I want that the riser must solidify after the casting, then for that the time of the solidification of the riser must be greater than the time of solidification of the casting. That means I want that the time of solidification of the riser must be as high as possible. Now to increase this, what we can do? Either we can increase the volume or we can decrease the area. We must decrease the area. Area of the riser must be decreased so that there is minimum heat transfer rate. अगर minimum heat transfer rate हो गया तो क्या होगा कि ज़्यादा ज़्यादा जो हमारा material है वो देर में सोलिडिफाई होगा. तो मिनिमम एरिया फॉर अ गिवन वॉल्यूम ऑफ द राइजर, स्फीयर इज हैविंग मिनिमम सरफेस एरिया टू द वॉल्यूम रेशियो. और मिनिमम सरफेस एरिया ऑफ द वॉल्यूम रेशियो कम होने से ज्यादा ये है कि एरिया जो है वो हमारा मिनिमम होगा, बट इट इज नॉट यूज एज द शेप ऑफ द राइजर. स्फीयर का भले ही क्या होता है कि सरफेस एरिया क्या होता है कि वो मिनिमम होता है, लेकिन बट देन ऑल्सो इट इज नॉट यूज एज द राइजर. द रीजन बिहाइंड दैट इज कि वो जो हमारा कास्टिंग होगा ना, देखिए कास्टिंग है और दिस इज द राइजर. इफ द राइजर इज इन इफ द राइजर इज स्फेरिकल इन शेप, नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन, यू कैन सी दैट द पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट बिटवीन द राइजर एंड द casting is, it is point of contact, it is not that it, the point of contact is not, that means it is not getting the space. जब feeding हो रही होगी ये point of contact की वजह से ज्यादा material इसमें under entry कर ही नहीं पाएगा, because the area is not available. और दूसरी बात important ये है कि जो हमारा molten metal है that will be available in the center of the casting, center of the riser. So from the center of the riser it has go to the casting, but ड्यू टू पॉइंट कॉन्टैक्ट इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू डू दैट वेरी फीजिबली. तो हम क्या करते हैं कि आइडियल, फॉर द आइडियल केस स्फीयर मस्ट बी द राइजर, बट ड्यू टू दीज लिमिटेशंस स्फीयर इज नॉट यूज एज द राइजर. वॉट इज यूज एज द राइजर, सिलेंडर्स आर यूज एज द राइजर. जो यहां पर पहले से ही बना के रखा है, सिलेंडर आर यूज एज द राइजर. नाउ सी द एरिया पाई बाई फोर डी स्क्वायर इज अवेलेबल फॉर फीडिंग इन दिस केस, विच इज क्वाइट इनफ टू फीड द लिक्विड मेटल फ्रॉम द राइजर टू द कास्टिंग. सो वी आर टेकिंग सिलेंडर एज द सिलेंडर, सिलेंडर सिलेंडर एज द एरिया और द शेप ऑफ द कास्टिंग, सॉरी राइजर. Now, how many types of risers are available? See, there are two types of riser. I will put it down. Types of riser. There are two types of riser. One is side riser. If this is my casting, I hope this is visible to you. If this is casting and this thing is a riser. Now, this is what, this is my side riser. Side riser. एंड इफ दिस इज द कास्टिंग एंड ये ऊपर बना हुआ है तो ये क्या है हमारा, दिस इज अवर टॉप राइजर. नाउ सी वॉट इज हैपनिंग इज द सर्फेस एरिया दैट इज अवेलेबल टू द साइड राइजर विल बी वॉट इट विल बी पाई डी एच, इफ एच इज द हाइट ऑफ द राइजर एंड डी डी इज द डायमीटर एंड एच इज द हाइट ऑफ द राइजर, देन एरिया सर्फेस एरिया दैट इज अवेलेबल टू द साइड राइजर इज टोटल सर्फेस एरिया पाई डी एच प्लस पाई बाई फोर डी स्क्वायर, ये ऊपर वाला एंड द नीचे वाला, तो आई विल हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई बाय टू. एंड फॉर द टॉप राइजर हाउ मच एरिया इज अवेलेबल, पाई डी एच प्लस पाई बाई फोर डी स्क्वायर. दिस टॉप इज ओनली अवेलेबल, बॉटम वाला तो ये कास्टिंग से हमारा जुड़ा हुआ है, सो दिस वन इज नॉट अवेलेबल एरिया फॉर दिस. नाउ दिस थिंग इज दैट दिस इज द एरिया विच इज अवेलेबल विद द टॉप राइजर एंड दिस इज द एरिया विच इज अवेलेबल विद द साइड राइजर. नाउ वॉट वी हैव टू डू इज वी हैव टू सी दैट the time of solidification of riser must be maximum. For that we have understood that agar time ko badhana hai then area must be decreased, so we have to find out an optimum condition. Optimum condition kya hoga, optimum condition ke liye we have to minimize the surface area. So what will be the relation between the diameter of this riser and the height of this riser to have the minimum surface area. So I will turn the page and start writing in this optimum condition. We are going to find out the optimum condition. Optimum condition. So we'll start first of all with number one, side riser. Now what here we are doing, we are trying to minimize the surface area. Now see, area for the side riser is 2 times of pi by 4 d square plus pi d h. Now see, V is the volume pi by 4 d square h. I am very sorry, in the last time when I was writing down last lecture, volume of the cylinder I have written pi d h by mistake, and one of the candidate or one of the student commented in that there is an error. But I hope that ki volume of the cylinder we have studied in our 6th standard, aap utna to idea laga hi sakte ho ki agar concept mein koi garbad hai then you can point it out. But aise choti mistakes ke liye, like ye 6th standard mein humne padha hai yaar, har kisi ko pata hai, wo by mistake jaldi mein aisa ho gaya. So नाउ हियर चलो कंसेप्ट में आ जाते हैं. वॉल्यूम इज इक्वल टू पाई बाई फोर डी स्क्वायर एच. नाउ सी दैट वॉल्यूम वी हैव टू टेक एज कॉन्स्टेंट. इट इज टेकन एज कॉन्स्टेंट, इज टेकन एज कॉन्स्टेंट as it represents the amount of total heat available which will be constant. See that heat available with the riser will be constant, right? So volume is taken as constant as it represents, I will write it down because this is an important point, as it represents the amount of heat available which will be constant. Now see, now this is taken as constant. So again, we have to find out the relation between the diameter of the riser. This is the side riser, diameter of the riser and the height of the riser. So what will happen? It area is equal to 2 times of pi by 4. ये small d लिखा हुआ है, इसको capital D कर लीजिए. या चलिए कोई बात नहीं, capital D कर लीजिए. D square plus pi d. Here what I will do is I will replace the h with the help of volume. So what it will be, what it will be, you have to understand that let me say that ki h is equal to what? H is equal to 4 v by pi d square. This is also capital D. So from here at the place of h we'll write as 4 v by pi d square. This and this then cancelled out and area is equal to pi by 2 d square plus 4 v by d. Now to minimize the area, we have to use maxima and minima. Then it is very simple, d a by d d. तो क्या होगा, पाई बाय 2 डी स्क्वायर का डिफरेंशिएशन इज 2d प्लस 4v, 1 बाय d का डिफरेंशिएशन इज माइनस 1 अपॉन d स्क्वायर. नाउ पुट इट इक्वल टू 0 एंड फ्रॉम हियर बाय सॉल्विंग यू विल गेट d इज इक्वल टू h. दैट मींस टू मिनिमाइज द सरफेस एरिया ऑफ द साइड राइजर यू नीड दिस कंडीशन दैट d मस्ट बी, दैट मींस द डायमीटर मस्ट बी इक्वल टू द हाइट ऑफ द राइजर. नाउ अगेन v बाय एरिया, we must find out v by area. V is what? Pi by 4 d square h upon pi d h plus 2 times of pi by 4 d square. And now everywhere put d is equal to h, d is equal to h. You will get volume by area as d by 6. Now you must remember this. This is very important that for the riser, the diameter must be equal to h to have the optimum condition and to minimize the surface area so that to maximize the time of solidification of the riser so that the riser must solidify after the casting has got solidified. So for that volume by area, see for the solidification time again and again you will need the volume by area, volume by area. So from here we have found out the volume of area when it is the side riser, d is equal to h, it will come capital D. Sorry, again I have written this. Capital D by H. Capital D by H. The same thing we must also derive for the side riser. Sorry, top riser. Second is top riser. See, the top riser, the area that is available for the type top riser is pi by 4 D square plus pi D H. Again, the volume will be constant as it was above. V is equal to pi by 4 d square h and here at the place of h you will write down, then you will get that pi by 4 d square plus 4 by pi v by d. Here again what you have to do to minimize the surface area, you have to do the maxima and minima, then d a by d d is going to be equal to pi by 4 2d plus 4 by pi v minus 1 by d square. And now you will put it, again you will put it equal to 0, then you will get it as h equal to d by 2. H equal to d by 2. Here, now you can see that at the time of side riser, we got it at that the diameter must be equal to height. Now here in the top riser, we have got that the diameter must be equal to twice of the height. Again, we can find out because for the solidification time, we need the volume by area whole square. So volume by area, we must find out. So volume by area is again, if you will put down the value, please put down the value. I'm directly writing down the result. Again, it will come d by 6. Which is coming same as this one. Now what we will do is we'll put write all the things in one make the कॉलम, दिस इज साइड राइजर, दिस इज टॉप राइजर. नाउ सी, फॉर द साइड राइजर वी हैव सेड दैट फॉर द ऑप्टिमम कंडीशन डी मस्ट बी इक्वल टू एच एंड वी बाय एरिया मस्ट बी इक्वल टू डी बाय 6. लेट अस मेक, दिस इज अ काइंड ऑफ बॉक्स. एंड फॉर द टॉप राइजर वॉट वी फाउंड आउट दैट द 2H must be equal to D and V by area is also equal to D by 6. Now here you can see that the ratio is not getting affected. V by A, D by 6 is coming. It is not getting affected. Here to minimize the area, what we have to do is to minimize the area, we have to decrease the height. See, for decrease the height from the top riser. Now, for example, let me say that if you have been using the top riser may the volume to area ratio is coming D by 6 for the optimum time, for the optimum condition, then the diameter must be equal to 2H, means the height is greater. But when you are using side riser, then the height is equal to diameter. That means the height of the top riser will be more than the height of the side riser. You must understand that. So this was the condition for, and you have to remember this, because most of the questions in the gate that are coming, no, they will be based on this only. So you must remember it so that aapko dikkat na ho. Now we'll see the riser design, basic riser design. Riser design, what are the conditions for riser design? Dekhi, riser design ke liye there are many conditions. One or two we are going to discuss. After that there is also Keynes method, there is modified Keynes method, and also there is modulus method, jisme ki gate mein they have asked questions many time, so we are going to see that. But before that, riser ka design. Acha, first of all dekhiye, what are the methods to increase the performance of the riser? Like methods, first let us discuss methods to increase the performance of the riser. Now see, first of all you want that, see, basic thing you must keep in mind. Ek tagline pakad lijiye, usi tagline ko lekar ke aap sari cheezon ko bilkul fit karke rakhiye. The tagline, what was the tagline for us? That we wanted that the solidification time for the riser must be greater than the solidification time of the casting, so that when the casting solidifies, there must be liquid metal available inside the riser to feed it at the time of the requirement, at the time of the shrinkage. So hum uske liye kya karenge? Number one is insulated material. If you are going to insulate the riser, insulate the riser by some other material, then what will happen is, due to insulation, the heat will not conduct very easily, and if the heat will not conduct, there will be available heat content, then the riser will not solidify. This is a very good thing to do, but practically it is like tough to insulate, because the riser is also made inside the sand, no, sand casting, so it is very tough to do that. Then next is, use some exothermic material. This is also a very good thing that you can do. Exothermic material is what? Which can give the heat. If they can get the heat, then our casting will solidify. Sorry, our riser will solidify later on. Next thing is, third thing is that optimization jo hume karna tha. For side riser, we can say that H must be equal to D for side riser. And for top riser, H must be equal to D by 2. This is for top riser. And the fourth thing is to do is to use a blind riser. Now what is a blind riser? Dekh lete hain. To use a blind riser. Blind riser is something like this. I'll make the figure. This is the casting. This is the casting, and ye dekhiye. Now the difference is that in above the riser there is sand. The riser is not open to the environment. So what will happen in that case of top riser? The molding sand is covered to the riser. So because of the molding sand, the heat transfer rate will decrease. If the heat transfer rate due to radiation or conduction or convection, whatever, will decrease, no? Sorry, conduction, how conduction, not convection, and the radiation will decrease, then हमारी राइजर जो है, देन अगेन इट विल टेक टाइम टू सॉलिडिफाई. नाउ दैट इज व्हाट वी वांटेड. सो दीज आर द फोर मेथड्स टू इंक्रीज द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ द राइजर. नाउ वी हैव टू सी दैट व्हाट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस आर कमिंग एंड हाउ यू हैव टू सॉल्व दोस क्वेश्चंस, बिकॉज एनी हाउ क्वेश्चंस निकलने चाहिए आपके पेपर में. देखिए राइजर डिजाइन के लिए फर्स्ट कंडीशन फर्स्ट एंड वेरी मोस्ट कंडीशन इज दैट द टाइम ऑफ द राइजर टाइम ऑफ द सॉलिडिफिकेशन ऑफ द राइजर मस्ट बी ग्रेटर दैन टाइम ऑफ सॉलिडिफिकेशन ऑफ द राइजर मस्ट बी ग्रेटर दैन और इक्वल टू नॉट इवन इक्वल टू मे बी इक्वल टू ऑल्सो यू कैन से दैट टाइम ऑफ सॉलिडिफिकेशन ऑफ कास्टिंग. सी टाइम इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू वॉल्यूम बाई एरिया का होल स्क्वायर. सो इफ यू आर रिमूविंग द होल स्क्वायर देन यू कैन से दैट वॉल्यूम बाई एरिया ऑफ द राइजर मस्ट बी ग्रेटर दैन इक्वल टू वॉल्यूम बाई एरिया ऑफ द कास्टिंग एनी हाउ. यू मस्ट सेटिस्फाई दिस कंडीशन फॉर योर बेटर डिजाइन ऑफ द राइजर. नाउ सेकेंड थिंग दीज टू कंडीशन मस्ट सेटिस्फाई फॉर अ बेटर डिजाइन ऑफ अ राइजर. सेकेंड थिंग वॉट इट मस्ट बी लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेट मी से एस इज द परसेंटेज श्रिंकेज ऑफ कास्टिंग. नाउ सी इफ एस इज द परसेंटेज श्रिंकेज ऑफ कास्टिंग. Now, this is very clear that the volume of the riser must be greater than the percentage shrinkage, no, then S percent of volume of the casting. Percentage shrinkage must be something like that. So, percentage shrinkage of the casting. So, volume of the riser must be greater than percentage shrinkage of the casting. Then what will happen is you have to say that how many times, because if the volume of the riser will be equal to percentage shrinkage of the casting, then it is necessary that, because what will happen, no, in this, what you can see, where is the figure? There isn't any figure. Now here you can see that. See, now what has happened, if the percentage shrinkage of the casting only, the volume of the riser, then maybe, for example, let me say that this 100 is the percentage shrinkage and you may also making 100 to the giving to the riser. Now, in that case, what will happen is, ki little bit solidification will happen, no, in the outer side. Then what will happen is, 50 will solidify, 50 will be left out in the center, then only 50 will be filled. So, in that case also, you will not get a better casting. So, here we want that the volume of the riser must be equal to 3 to 5 times of the percentage shrinkage of the casting. You must remember, see, if in the, there are many other methods I have already told, there is Kane's method, there is modified Kane's methods, and there is modulus method. The names are there to the methods. If these names are not given in the question, we'll discuss about these methods in our later lectures. If these names are not given in the question and they have asked you to design the riser, then you must remember that these both conditions must be satisfied. Because see, in the question, they will give you that how many times this must be. 3 to 4 times, from here also you will get some volume of the riser. Then you have to satisfy this condition. From here also you will get some volume of the riser. So whatever will be the optimum, whatever will be the required, that only you have to take as your answer. So both the conditions must be satisfied. We'll solve some of the questions regarding this. But after completing our most of the syllabus, because most of the students are telling to complete the syllabus as soon as possible. So what I'll do is, here we have discussed about this much design of the riser. In the next lecture, we'll discuss about other 3 methods for the design of the riser. Then we'll see the types of the casting. And after that, we'll also see some of the questions that have come in the gate, and we'll apply the concepts that we have studied to understand that better. Hello friends, let us see the rest of the portion which is left out of the riser design. In this, the riser design, the first one method we have already seen, I'll show you it to you here, that for solving the question, the time of the riser, that is the time of the riser must be greater than the time of the casting. So time of the riser is directly proportional to k times of v by a ka whole square. From that whole square part we have left out, and v by area, that is volume by area of the riser, must be greater than or equal to the volume by area of the casting. And the second point that must be satisfied for a good riser is that volume of the riser is equal to 3 to 5 times the percentage shrinkage of the casting. So now first of all see that the volume by area of the riser, which is greater than the volume of area of the casting. This is the second method, which is known as modulus method of riser design. See what is that? V by A is also called as the modulus. It is also called as the modulus. So in the first part we have already seen that the modulus of the riser must be greater than or equal to the modulus of the casting. You know that. Now in the modulus method, see, in the modulus method what is happening is, this is the previous thing that we have seen, but it is greater than, we know that the modulus of the riser must be greater than the modulus of the casting, but how much greater than it should be? Then the in the modular method it is said that the modulus of the riser must be 20% greater than the modulus of the casting. So according to this method, the modulus of the riser must be 20% greater, must be 20% of the volume of the modulus of the casting. So it is like 20%, so 1.2 of the modulus of the casting. So we can say that volume by area of the riser is equal to 1.2. That means 20% more than the modulus of the casting. No, so volume by area of the casting. So in the question, if it is ever asked to find out the dimension of your riser using the modulus method, then you must remember that the modulus of the riser must be equal to 1.2 times the modulus of the casting, or in the other words you can say that the modulus of the riser is 20% greater than the modulus of the casting. So this is one of the method, and already the gate questions have come. Hum jab hamari series hogi questions wali, I'll try to make the question and show it to you. So jab wo series hogi, we'll be solving the question regarding this. Until then, let us move to the next part. Next is third, that is Keynes method. See, Keynes is a scientist. He gave the method for the design of the riser. So first of all, for solving the Keynes method, here we have to see that one term that is defined is freezing ratio. Freezing ratio is equal to modulus of the riser upon modulus of the casting, that is volume by area of the riser upon volume by area of the casting. Now you already know that from here that the modulus of the riser is always greater than modulus of the casting. If it is not there, if it is, this condition is not satisfied, then that means the riser will solidify before, which we don't want. We want that the riser must solidify after the casting. So for this condition, we always know that the modulus of the riser must be always greater than the modulus of the casting. So this value is always greater than 1. So now what we have to do is, we also have one more parameter which is called as Y. Y is known as volume of the riser upon the volume of the casting. Now we have to draw a graph of X versus Y. This is X versus Y. Now X is what? X is the freezing ratio, FR, which is denoted by FR, and Y is what? Volume of the riser upon the volume of the casting. And you know that the freezing ratio is always greater than 1. So let me make one line which denotes that freezing ratio is equal to 1. Now if the freezing ratio is equal to 1, what will happen is that freezing ratio is equal to 1. And one more line. Now I have drawn this line. Now if we say that sometimes the freezing ratio is tending to infinity, what will be the value of Y? So if the freezing ratio is tending to infinity or is equal to infinity, then you must know that freezing ratio is equal to MR upon MC. If this is tending to infinity, then modulus of the casting is equal to 0. If this is 0, then only freezing ratio will get to infinity. If modulus of the casting is 0, then you know that the time of solidification of the casting is some k times of volume by area of the casting ka whole square. Then this is only, or other words I can say that the time of the solidification of the casting is equal to k times of modulus of the casting ka whole square. If the modulus of the casting is 0, then that means what? The volume of the casting is also 0. Then that means volume of the casting is, this thing is 0, volume of the, sorry, not the volume of the casting. If this thing is 0, then that means time of solidification of the casting is also 0. That means there is instantaneous 10 years solidification, that means at no time the casting is getting solidified. So if at no time the casting is getting solidified, time is zero, then what will happen is the riser is not needed. Jab zero time mein casting hamari solidify ho ja rahi hai, to riser ki zarurat hi kya hai usko fill up karne ke liye, because when there is no need of the riser, so we can say that the volume of the riser will tend to zero. The volume of the riser will tend to zero, then that means that the y, which is equal to volume of the riser upon the volume of the casting, will also tend to zero. That means that when the fr is reaching infinity, y is reaching zero, and when fr is reaching one, y is reaching infinite. So when we have to draw the graph diagram, so this is a kind of hyperbola. What hyperbola it is? We'll draw the hyperbola. See, it will be something like this. Now, this line is known as, this line is for the Keynes method. Now, whatever points will lie on these lines, they will be just the sound casting. And if you're going to move above this graph, then you will get a sound or good casting. And here you will get a defective casting. So therefore, whenever, like, if some freezing ratio is given in the question, then you can find out the value of y. It will be from the graph, and from the value of y you can also find out the volume of the riser. So from this way you can derive the value of the riser. So this was one of the method to find out the volume of the riser and the designing of the riser. Now let us move to the next method, which is known as modified Keynes method or Neville Research Laboratory method. I'll put down the heading first of all. Neville Research Laboratory method. This is also sometimes known as modified Keynes method. See, in this method what is happening is, this method question has come at many times, but let me tell you from the Keynes method, because Keynes method is used for calculating the dimension of the casting for a simple shape of the objects only. Because if the shape of the object is tough, no, then volume of the area ratio, finding out the volume of the volume and the area ratio becomes very tough. So Keynes method is used for only simple casting. So that is why the Keynes method was modified little bit, so that ki aapki jo bhi little bit tough dimension ki castings hai, unka nikala ja sake kya dimension of the riser. So here one factor is defined out. Here y is simply like the Keynes method only, volume of the riser upon the volume of the casting. And one more factor is defined, which is known as the shape factor. Shape factor SF, it is represented by SF, it is equal to length plus width upon thickness. And it is denoted by hamara. See, what is happening is, yahan par hum log dekh lete hain, in this also graph is drawn. Between shape factor and y, which is volume of the riser upon the volume of the casting. And this is also coming somewhat the same as that. So in this method, if you are going above, then this is sound or good casting. And if you are going below this line, then it will be a defective casting. So what is happening is, like for example, you have got in the question the shape factor is given at this point, then you have to take y which is above this point. All the points will get the good casting. If you are coming below this, you are going to get a defective casting. So for the given shape factor, the value of y, that is volume of the riser upon the volume of the casting, must always be above to this graph. Now for complex shape, see what will happen in the question. What will happen, they will give you the shape factor, and corresponding to the shape factor, different values of VR upon VC will be given. For example, if the value of the shape factor L plus W upon thickness, but the length plus W upon thickness, that width upon thickness is coming somewhat here, then you have to take volume by riser something. If for example it is given A, then volume of riser upon volume of the casting will be equal to A, and from here you can find out the volume of the riser is equal to A times of volume of the casting. So this is the method to solve this. Now let us see that we have to, how to find out the shape factor. So for a cube, shape factor for the cube इज इक्वल टू लाइक क्यूब इज ए ए ए ए क्रॉस ए क्रॉस ए, तो ए मल्टीप्लाई बाई ए अपॉन ए, सॉरी नॉट मल्टीप्लाई बाई, सॉरी नॉट मल्टीप्लाई बाई, ए प्लस ए अपॉन ए, इट इज इक्वल टू टू. नाउ शेप फैक्टर फॉर अ स्फीयर. See, if sphere both the dimensions or all the three dimensions are similar but is equal to diameter, then diameter plus diameter upon diameter which is also equal to 2. Now, shape factor for a slab. For a slab, length plus breadth upon height. And now, also one thing more, shape factor for the cylinder. Height plus diameter upon diameter. So, these are the things in which you can find out the diameter, and by finding out the diameter, you can, with the help of all the three dimensions, you can find out the shape factor. By finding the shape factor, just look out with which number shape factor is matching with the value of VR by VC. Then by finding the VR by VC, you can find out the volume of the riser. So these are total four methods totally for design of the riser. And you have to take care of each and every method. You have to remember each and every method because questions can be asked from any of the following. So we'll do the question, but first we'll try to complete our casting. And from after completing the casting, because more parts are left out about the type of the casting, after completing that only we'll solve the question. I'll try to do that. Till then next we'll see that chills and padding and also the types of the casting.